You know, there is a way we can get action figures to look exactly like us.
Oh, yeah, how's that?
Two words, 3D printer. But maybe it's three words.
If you are a 3D printing enthusiast wondering how a 3D scanner works, then you are at the right place. I'm a 3D printing enthusiast myself. I even built my own 3D printer, which I'm pretty proud of. While working in the 3D printing industry, I had a lot of demands on 3D scanning. What everybody knows about 3D scanning is that you can take an object and transform it into a digital 3D model. Pretty simple, right?
Okay, give me a superhero pose and I will scan you into the computer for your action figure.
Well, from my experience, it's not that simple. 3D printing and 3D scanning is not as simple as printing on paper or scanning a document. The third dimension brings a whole lot of variables to the table that complicates things. I'm Max from LifeHackerMax and in this video I'm attempting to 3D scan this little angry fellow using a 3D laser scanner from Nextengine. I will take you through the process of 3D scanning and underline a few things that you need to know when planning on 3D scanning an object. There are many 3D scanning technologies, some more accurate than others, some are cheap, others are very expensive. Each has its own utility and purpose in the three-dimensional world. For example, contact probing, where the scanner probes the object through physical touch, calculating the position of different points on the surface of the object. Photogrammetry, where multiple images of the object are taken from different angles, and a specially designed software analyzes all the photos to find matching points and figures out the position of those points in three-dimensional space. Photogrammetry is very popular because it allows you to build a 3D model using a camera or even your smartphone, and there are lots of free softwares out there that you can take advantage of and get a 3D model for cheap. Structured light 3D scanners project a pattern of light on the subject and look at the deformation of the pattern, figuring out the shape of the object. Computerized tomography. CT scanners produce sets of 2D slices, which are then stacked together to produce a 3D representation. Sonography, where the scanner uses ultrasound technology in order to build a 3D model.
This can't be happening.
But it is.
Laser scanning is a method to sample or scan a surface using laser technology. Laser technology, which we will use for our 3D scan, uses a laser beam and a camera to triangulate the position in space of different points located on the surface of the object, thus creating a digital 3D model. This particular laser scanner that I'm using is an older model, and even though it's the best 3D scanner that I've worked with so far, it still has its own limitations. I chose this figure for my scan because it has some traits that make the scanning difficult. The perfect pick for underlining what to look at when thinking about scanning an object. Transparent shapes like the orb and the base of my figure will not get captured by the scanner. The laser goes through the transparent surface, making the area invisible. Shiny objects like mirror, chrome, or glossy surfaces will not get captured by the scanner because the laser is reflected. To reduce the shine or transparency, I covered the surface of my object in baby powder. Unreachable areas like holes and narrow spaces are hard to get scanned. The inside of Anger's mouth, for example. Scanned technical precise parts like threads and gears are most likely not to be accurate, and it is better to model them in a 3D software for more precision. To get more details, I scan the object twice. First time, I placed the object flat on the rotating table, and the second time, I placed it at an angle. Yes! You can combine two different sets of scans together in order to form a more accurate model. The final result will need post-processing most of the time in order to get the model ready for 3D printing. This involves having some knowledge on 3D modeling. Not much, but if you are not that into computers or 3D manipulation software, you might want to get some professional help instead of deciding on buying a 3D scanner yourself. But enough talk, let's get some actual work done. Let me show you how it works. The scanner is composed from two parts, the main body that gathers all the information of the object, and a rotating table that changes the position of the object. The rotating table allows me to make multiple 3D scans and then blend them together to form a complete 3D model. I had great results with it in the past, managing to capture some fine details of complex objects where other scanners failed. After setting up the scanner and connecting it to the software, I placed the object on the rotating table. The scanner does not work without its software, called Nextengine Scan Studio, and the software has a license that works on one computer. If I want to use the scanner on a different computer, I have to request a new license from the producer. There are some settings that you can alter depending on what you are scanning in order to achieve the best quality model possible. I'm not using the scanner on a daily basis, so I'm doing my best to choose the right settings for my model. This scanner can scan large objects using the white function or macro scanning, capturing fine details up to 100 microns precision, or so they say on their website. I am planning to do a full 360 degree rotation macro scanning, so I set up the software to do a 360 degrees rotation scan with 12 divisions, which means that I would get one surface scan every 30 degrees. I set the precision to macro and the speed to fine. A slower speed allows the software to get a more accurate reading on the object. Based on those settings, I calculate that the scan will take about 25 to 30 minutes without the post-processing needed to get the final 3D model. On the target settings, I tried different settings, as I did 5 or 6 scans to see what works best. And for my figure, the best setting was 40% on the surface and matte finish. I didn't alter the processing setting, even though I think that choosing a smaller triangle size would probably result in a better quality model. After that, I hit the start button and let the scanner do his job. First, the scanner takes a photo of the object. This enables you to get a color 3D model in the end. Then, the surface scanning process starts, where the scanner analyzes the whole surface of the object and transforms it into digital form. This process will take 1 or 2 minutes depending on the chosen settings. After the scanning is done, the table turns the object and the process is repeated until the whole object is rotated a full 360 degrees. When the scanner is done, I end up with a bunch of 3D meshes that look more like a fan than my actual model. Here is where the post-processing starts. I need to align the scans. This means repositioning each scan in order to get an accurate representation of the original. Luckily, the software comes with an automation tool that makes this process quite easy. I have to set at least 3 matching points on 2 different scans, and the software does the alignment automatically. I had different results depending on the scanned object. Some alignments went very well, others needed further alignment in third-party softwares. I can recommend MeshLab and Meshmixer for post-processing 3D scanned surfaces. I simply save my 3D scan as individual STL files and import them into any other 3D software. STL files are easily imported in a lot of 3D modeling softwares. After the scans are aligned, I still have to clean and close the mesh in order to have a 3D model that can be 3D printed. And this is the final model. You can see that it's pretty rough. I could have spent a bit more time on the modeling part and making the final model look better. But the point of this video was to show you how a scanner works and what you can get from a 3D scanner without too much post-processing. What software are you using for modeling your 3D parts? Do you think the scan was a success or it could have gone better? Do you get better results with your 3D scanner? What scanner are you guys using? Feel free to leave me a comment. I will leave a bunch of useful information in the description, as well as a link where you can download the 3D scanned files and the final model. This way, you can analyze the files or even try out the post-processing operations for yourself. Good luck and thank you for watching!